So we bring in Mike Robinson now. Obviously, that huge day against St. Joe's earlier this week. But, Mike, I went to your bio in researching for this interview and said one of your career objectives is to be the Prime Minister of Canada. I just want to know where that came from and why that is a goal of yours.
I remember doing that. I was talking to my friends, and they thought it'd be pretty funny if I put that because I had really no idea what I wanted to do when I grew up. So, I don't know if that's entirely true, but I guess it's a shot.
I mean, there's nothing wrong with having some fun with that. I mean, you got to shoot high. I mean, aim high if you don't know. That's a beautiful thing. So we get to the game now. You scored 9 goals against St. Joe's, I guess. I mean, when was the last time you had that many in a game?
That was a career high for me. Last year I had 7, I think, against Mount St. Mary's. But even back in high school, I don't think I've ever had 9.
Yeah, what a performance so far for you this year. And obviously an interesting start for you guys. I mean, that first game, I guess, what you learn from not being able to play in all of that, from that experience?
That was tough. That was the first game in a while I've ever had to sit back and watch, and kind of it's a helpless feeling, really. So seeing them lose was pretty tough, just sitting at home on my couch watching the game. But definitely fueled the fire a little bit for the rest of the season, and I think we learned a lot from that game moving forward, and I look forward to trying to keep this ball rolling for the rest of the year.
Did that open your eyes, I guess, a little bit more in terms of what sort of has to happen to off the field for you guys to be successful and moving, you know, towards getting this year and being as good as you can be as the rest of the season?
Yeah, I mean, obviously with everything going on with COVID, I mean, it's tough, but like moving forward, we got to take every precaution we can to make sure that we can field our best team possible on every Saturday, every game day. So moving forward, yeah, hopefully we can stay away from quarantine and stay away from any positive case on our team. Right now it looks good, so just try to move forward.
I wonder, you know, because you guys came into last year and you were a freshman, of course, with such high expectations, and there was a couple of bumps in the road before the pandemic stoppage and all of that. What did you take away from that and sort of the off season and sort of rebooting for this year, knowing you had some high expectations, you guys weren't maybe living up to those last year? What did you take away from that going into this year?
I mean, the biggest thing is just taking one game at a time. I mean, we know that anybody can beat anybody on any given Sunday. So, I mean, just preparing as much as well as we can for every game. Our coaching staff does a great job of getting us ready and knowing what our opponent's going to bring to us. So doing it whatever we can for every opponent, not looking forward, not looking past any game, and just taking it one game at a time.
What have you learned from some of these upperclassmen? I mean, we've all read, and I mean, I've spoke to Charlie Kitchen a few times about some of his unique nature, just his personality and whatnot. I guess, and him in particular, what sort of stuck out about him to you, you know, upon meeting him last year and getting to know him a little bit?
I mean, yeah, it's awesome. He kind of took me under his wing last year, him and Ty as well, on our attack line. And I mean, definitely an interesting guy, but made me feel right at home once I got here right away. So, I mean, kudos to him because he's a big name on campus. He's a big guy in the lacrosse world and one of the best players I've ever had the opportunity to play with. But, I mean, the nerves aren't really a thing when you're around Charlie. He keeps it pretty light. And definitely a great guy to have on the team.
Is there an aspect of his personality that surprised you at all, or something that he like did off the field or whatever?
When I found out he started giving himself his own tattoos, that definitely took me back a little bit. But I mean, kudos to him for that.
Yeah, I mean, that's one way to do it for sure. I guess what is that? I mean, obviously every team is sort of dealing with a different dynamic this year and having guys come back for an extra year, taking that grad year as well. What do you think that's done for you guys?
I mean, that's huge. I mean, we have 3 captains now that are all fifth-year seniors and then a fourth-year senior. So just having that leadership and that veteran presence in the locker room is big, especially for the young guys on the team.
Yeah, absolutely. And as you look forward now, we mentioned you have Bellarmine on short notice coming up here this weekend. Is that sort of the dynamic of the season? You got to be able to, you know, roll with the punches a bit?
Yeah, exactly. I mean, you never really know what's going to happen. We're trying to get as many games on our schedule as possible. And, you know, any team that wants to play, we want to play. So, you just kind of be able to pivot, be ready to pivot and take whatever's coming at you.
Anywhere, anytime, right? I mean, that's the mentality it feels like this year.
Exactly.
Mike, we appreciate you so much for doing this. And good luck against Bellarmine this weekend and moving forward as well.
Thank you very much. Appreciate it.